Hello, my name is Grace Kirago, working in archives section. I'm going to take you through what we have preserved in our university archive. First, I would want to let you know where we have the section. The archive section is located in the basement of Jomo Kenyatta Memorial Library. Our working hours are from 8 to 4, Monday to Friday. The University of Nairobi Archive was officially designated as a place where public archives may be preserved, and this was through the publication of Kenya Gazette Notice number 3662 of 14th November 1974. However, it was not until 1978 that a professional archivist was appointed to the library staff. The objective of establishing the university archive was to preserve records that were generated since the university was started. That was way back in 1950s. There were so many records that were accumulated, and the university administration needed a place to preserve these records for future reference. So most of the records that are preserved in our university archive are therefore generated by the university. Others are donated as private collection as compared to National Archive, where we have public records. Since the university archive is academic, we have preserved records that can only be used by researchers, our students, and staff members. So I just want to take you through the various types of records that we have been able to preserve in this section. And these are records generated by the university since it was started in 1950s. Namely, the Royal Technical College records, University of East Africa records, and University of Nairobi records. These records comprise of agendas and minutes of various committee meetings of the University of Nairobi. We have also preserved personnel records. These are closed files for officers in lecturers, grade, equivalent, and above. We also have booklets for graduation and copies of varsity focus. Apart from the records that are generated by the university, we've been able to preserve various records donated by individuals, and we refer to them as private collections. And these are records that are donated by the public to the university, and they contribute to the growth of the institution's collection. And these information materials are valuable to historians, these are researchers, and also the students, and they are dated 1920s to 1973. Just to mention a few of them, we have the Dare and Fages files. This is one of the oldest and well-established legal institutions since pre-colonial Kenya. The records comprise of civil cases, criminal cases, probate administration, and others. We also have a collection of Rabat. He was a settler and came to Kenya in 1913 and served as a district commissioner in Kiambu, Embu, Kitui, and Meru from 1919 to 1940. These are administrative papers, Rabitena language, which include Kiswahili and other languages. We also have the Baru collection, who was a Scotland Church missionary, who intensively researched on Kuyu language traditions and also studied other languages. We have Hoji Papers, who came to Kenya in 1914 as a settler and worked as a district commissioner for Southern Karachuonyo district in Kisii between 1927 and 1929. His collection contains records of diaries detailing the learning of his farm, which is known Sidai Farm, and other administrative records. We also have a collection of Makan Singh. This is also very known by the historians. He was a trade unionist in Kenya. His records comprises of general correspondence and press cuttings on trade union matters, as well as what he recorded when he was in detention. We also have Lord Francis Court. He was a settler and farmer. He had a estate called the Loraine Estate. We also have other several collections for various people. And once you come to the archive section, the guides are there for each collection, and researchers can use the guides to search for the information that they require. Apart from private collection and university records, we have preserved newspapers. The collection of newspapers comprise of colonial and daily newspapers dated 1911 to 1985. These are mostly used by researchers as well as undergraduate students. These include the East African Standard, Daily Nation, Mombasa Times, Balasa, the Kenya Daily Mail, Tanganyika Standard, Uganda Argus, Sunday Post, Ramogi Weekly, and others. Concerning user services within the archive section, the archive collection operates on a concept of closed access. A researcher will normally come to the archives room and talk to a member of staff, who then introduces him or her to the formalities governing the use of such a collection. The archival materials are not borrowed, but photocopying, use of camera or smartphones is allowed, especially for newspapers. We have various users of archive, and these include members of staff of the university who use the record to transact their business and also for teaching purposes. Undergraduate and postgraduate students also come to use newspapers and other information sources that we have. We also have bona fide researchers. These are internal as well as external, who consult the information materials that we have for information to support their research. We also have registered members of public seeking information from the world of newspaper collection. In order to preserve our records or to protect them, we do have some rules in the section. And to protect the documents, researchers are required to conform to certain search room procedures, which generally require identification and registration to use archives. We only allow those who are registered or those who have permission from the university to use our archival materials. You are all welcome to come and use our archival materials, which can support you in whatever you do as a researcher. Thank you.